Hi, it's Vicky here, and welcome back. Today I'm showcasing the latest Tonic Craft Kit, which is number 16. And first let's take a quick look on what's included, and then I'm going to share 4 cards that I created. First of all, you get a set of 3 markers. These are alcohol markers, and the set is called Aquamarines. The markers come with 2 nibs, and if you don't have any alcohol markers by Nuvo, then this is a great opportunity for you to try them out. You get a bottle of Nuvo Deluxe white glue. I absolutely love this one because it never clogs and it grabs quickly. This is a bottle of mica mist in Turkish rose color. This is a mini jewel drop in rose water, which is translucent. You also get this 6x6 paper pad. This is actually cardstock, it's not paper. It's nice and thick. It's about 250 GSM. There are 4 different designs in here, and you get 6 pages of each design. And as I'm trying to catch the light for you, probably you can tell that this cardstock, it is textured and shiny, really gorgeous, and I absolutely love those colors for wedding cards. This kit is perfect for wedding cards as well as anniversary and Valentine's cards, I believe. So let's take a look at the stamps and the dies that are in this kit, and I think they gave me 2 stickers this time. So anyway, let's take everything out and take a closer look. This die set includes 20 dies, some of them nest inside another, just like these ones, for example, where you get the outline, you get a lovely lace pattern, and you also actually get 3 different heart dies, as well as this last one that cuts out tiny little ones. And everything nests, as you can see, one inside the other, so you can play around and create different looks. Now, there is also a lovely key, as well as a keyhole, and also those 2 bears that are holding a little heart. Now, you also get a flower composition, along with a die that goes around it to cut it out. And I'm trying to find out how this matches. Now you also get these triangles that have beautiful rose details. And there are also a couple of roses that cut out a beautiful design, as well as a die that cuts out all around them. Now there is also a stamp set that gives you different hearts and little flowers, as well as a little tiny dove. This is a mini embossing powder. The color is Cool Jade, and again it goes beautifully with the rest of the colors in the kit. Now let's take a look at the cardstock that you get. I like that it comes in this heart envelope, so you know that they will be in perfect condition every time. This is a pearlescent pink one. You also get a beautiful ocean blue. This is a gorgeous paper. It is embossed and debossed on the other side. One side is actually shiny and it's really gorgeous. Now here's another embossed paper, which is amazing in real life. It has a lovely texture and it is called Mermaid Tail. And finally you get a grey cardstock. Now in the kit you will also get this notepad in a lovely orange color, which is always handy. So today I'm going for clean and simple cards, and I will be creating cards that are perfect for anniversaries as well as weddings. So I'm going to cut out the roses. And I'm using the pearlescent cardstock included in the kit. And you can see how gorgeous they look once you pop out all the little inside pieces. I actually cut out 3 of those roses, and they are going to be the focal point so that I can embellish my card. Now, I didn't cut only the roses, I also cut out their base, and I also cut out the word love. Everything is cut out from this piece of pearlescent cardstock. I also used this die that wasn't included in kit number 16. This comes from kit number 12, but if you are not a regular subscriber and you don't have the kit, you can use pretty much any leaf die that you maybe have on your stash, or you can just use your scissors like so to cut out little leaves to embellish your flowers. Now I'm going to put together my flowers. For that I will use some Nuvo Deluxe glue around the border of my flower and stick those pieces together. I am going for a pink on pink look, where you can see how gorgeous and elegant this looks. But of course you can play with the colors, like pink on white or pink on darker pink. So many different combinations there. So I have all my panels ready here. Everything is cut out from the mint blush paper pad, and I'm going to stick the white paper on top of the mint one, but first let's embellish it. I will use the flowers that I created, and I'm going to stick one of them directly on top with glue. So this is going to lay flat, and for the other two flowers I'm going to use a foam square at the back just to add some dimension. And I like to follow the rule of odd numbers for elements on your cards. So I have three flowers here, and I'm also going to stick three leaves. I am using my fingers over the leaves to add a slight curve so that they are dimensional. I'm going to add glue at the bottom of the leaves and just tuck them underneath the flowers. The white panel I'm working on is actually pearlescent, and it has a beautiful design that you will be able to see at the photos. Now, I will end up with a really elegant card in soft pink and mint colors, which I absolutely love. Now, I'm going to stick down the die cut that says love, and you can go with congratulations or happy birthday. It can be a really versatile card, this one. I used foam tape at the back to stick those panels together, and at the center you can either use the pink nouveau drop included in the kit, or I decided to go with a white one that I had in my stash just to add a different color at the center of my flowers. And here is my finished card, and you can see here some close-up photos where probably you can see better the beautiful texture on the cardstock. For my second card, I'm going to use this beautiful English lace paper, which I'm going to cut to be slightly smaller than a standard card, and then I'm going to stick that on top of a grey panel that I created from the cardstock in the kit. I'm going to embellish this beautiful paper a little bit more, and I will use my pink nouveau drop that was included in the kit to add a little dot inside the center of the flowers. I left everything to dry, and I have also cut out with this scalloped edge die this beautiful heart from the pattern paper. And as you can see, I have chopped off one side of this heart, and that's just because I like to add things off-centered. Of course, you can create pretty much the same thing by adding the whole heart at the center of your card. Now I'm going to place it. You can see it works either way, vertically or horizontally. I'm trying to decide where this is going to go. I'm going to place it on top. And then here is a lovely place where I can nest my die cut that says love. Moving on to the third card for today, I created this panel using the roses. I just ran it through my die cutting machine back and forth, every time changing the position of the two rose dies. Now I'm going to add my Nouveau Deluxe adhesive at the back, and I'm going to stick this panel on top of a piece of vellum. Now of course you can go directly on top of a different colored cardstock, or even the same colored cardstock for a tone-on-tone look. There are so many different ideas that you can go with this design. Now you can also create a shaker card out of this. I decided to go with vellum at the back for a very soft look. At the back I have placed little foam squares in between the holes so that it doesn't show through, and I'm going to stick it on top of my panel. I also die cut the word love that I can stick anywhere on top of my card to finish it off, but here I decided to use a layer of vellum underneath, which is going to help the sentiment pop a little bit more. I'm going to add nouveau glue at the back of the sentiment, stick it on top of my strip of vellum, and then I'm going to wrap that strip around my panel and just secure it at the back with some tape adhesive. To finish off my card, as you can probably tell from the close-up photos, I added a dot of the pink nouveau drop at the center of each and every flower. Now for the last card, I did some die cutting. I cut out a pink heart as well as the little birds out of white cardstock. And I'm going to place the die on top of the heart and just run it through my Big Shot. And I will end up with three pieces, but I am going to remove the middle piece, which are the pink birds, And instead I'm going to add inside the white birds that I have cut out previously. So I'm just going to put everything together just like a puzzle. And you can see how this is going to look once I place the little heart inside. I'm going to complete my little puzzle there. So a way to put everything together is to work directly on top of a card and just piece everything with glue at the back. For my case, since I always like to add dimension, I'm going to piece everything on top of this piece of scrap cardstock. I'm just going to cover it up completely with a tape runner. And this white piece of cardstock that I'm using as a base is not going to show at the end. It's just a way to put everything together. If something shows, like one end here, I'm just going to use my scissors and cut it out. And now it's time to put my card together. I have two panels here. Both of them are pearlescent. I'm sticking one on top of the other. And since I have created my little embellishment separately, I can now add some foam squares at the back so that I can add dimension and stick it on top of my card. Now you will see in the close-up photos that this is really textured and gives a beautiful shine, that it is really hard to catch with all the lighting that I have on my studio right now. The Tonic Craft Kits are always fun to work with. They are packed with products and I believe that they are great value for money. There are links down below in the description area as well as on my blog to both the UK shop as well as the USA shop where you can get this kit since it is still available. So these were the cards for today. I hope you had fun and you got inspired. Thank you all so much for watching today and I'll see you all next time.